Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. Today I will show you the game between Pavel Pankratov with an elo of 2622 versus Sergei Volkov with an elo of 2580. This is round 2 of Russian Higher League 2018 taking place in Yaroslav in Russia. It's an important tournament and also a strong tournament and I remember you that the top 5 players in the tournament will qualify for the 2018 Russian Championship Superfinal. Both Pankratov and Volkov won in the first round, so this is a match between two of the tournament leaders. And now let's start with the game. E4 for Pankratov, E6 the French defense for Volkov. D4, D5, Knight in C3, Knight in F6. Sorry. E5, so the classical variation. Knight in D7, F4, so we continue with the main line. C5, Knight in F3, Knight in C6, putting more pressure on the D-pawn. Bishop in E3, so Pankratov develops the bishop, also protecting the D-pawn, but also this move gives White the opportunity to castle long. Bishop in E7, Volkov keeps developing his king side to castle first and then to concentrate on expanding on the queen side. The other moves generally played in this position are A6 and C capture in D4. Now queen in D2 for White, so White seems oriented to castle long. Short castle for Black. D capture in C5, and generally here Black recapture with the bishop or the knight, but Volkov plays the interesting queen in A5. Long castle for White, and B6 for Black. Black wants to open the B file, capturing the C pawn, and if White capture in B6, then after A capture in B6, you see that Black is controlling with the queen and the rook the A-file, and then the B-pawn is ready to march and to open White castle. So that's why White doesn't capture in B6, but Pankratov plays the best move, that is Bishop in B5, attacking the undefended knight in C6. This knight goes in B4 because must move. Now there are two attacks on the A2 pawn. And A3 now. Bishop, sì, sorry, B capture in C5. And now the position is very interesting. Pankratov plays F5, but this is a mistake because it allows Knight in A2 we check. The best move instead of F5 was King in B1. As I said, the position here is complex and there are many interesting lines to watch. Let's come back one move. So, of course, instead of playing F5, of course, White can't play A capture B4 because after C capture in B4, the pawn attacks the knight that is defending the bishop, so the knight must move in A4, queen capture in B5, attacking the knight, and after B3 that protect the knight, here Black is much better. So coming back, we said instead of F5, bishop capture in D7, this line seems to win a piece, and in fact it win a piece, but not the game. In fact, after bishop capture in d7, we can continue with bishop capture in d7, a capture in b4, so White wins one piece. C capture in b4, attacking the knight. Knight in b1. Rook in f in c8. Bishop in d4. Rook in c7 because Black is doubling the rook on the c-file. Rook in f1, rook in c8, Now, rook in f2, and even with a piece less, black seems better, because white can only defend this position, and there are many dangerous attacking possibilities, such as queen in a2, then bishop in a4, a5, and marching on. So, it's a dangerous position for white. That's why Pankratov doesn't go for this line. But he played f5, and as we said, this move allows knight of course d4, this fork seems good, but is not, because after a capture in b4, c capture in b4, knight capture in d4, also protecting the bishop, b capture in c3, and queen capture in c3, and the game is equal. The best move after f5 is knight in a2 we check. Now knight capture in a2, queen capture in b5, knight in c3 attacking the queen in b6, and also for the computer, yes, black is a bit better. Bishop in g5, move the bishop to avoid the fork now, before defending the bishop, black plays rook in b8, because the threat now is mate in 1 and must be addressed with knight in a4 that attack the queen and also protect b2, queen in d8 that comebacks to protect the bishop, h4, bishop in b7, because black relocate the bishop on the long diagonal. Queen in f4, e capture in f5, queen capture in f5, bishop in c6. This is a good move because attack the undefended knight. Knight come back in c3, so we have a double attack on this pawn that moves forward. d4 attacking the knight, knight in e4. Now black exchange the bishop on the knight, bishop capture e4, queen capture in e4, rook in b6, expanding the scope of the rook, and also this move will allow some doubling of the rooks in some files. Now rook in d goes in e1, h6. That seems to threaten the bishop, but this threat is just virtual, because capturing the bishop would be lethal after white will recapture with the pawn, because then the queen and the rook will destroy black position. Queen in f5 for white, rook in e8, rook in f1, knight in f8, bishop capture in e7, rook capture in e7, a6, that of course this pawn must be captured, because it's boring here, and then this e6 opens the attack of the queen on the c5 pawn. So rook in b capture in e6, queen capture in c5. Now we have two attack on the d-pawn. So rook in d6 that not only defend the pawn, also leaves d square for the knight. We have king in b1, knight in e6, attacking the queen in f5. Rook in d5, again attacking the queen, that retreat in g4, and now rook in b7, and we see that the heavy pieces now are coming to the queen side, that is completely open, and the attack is very strong. Knight in e1, queen in b6, of course the threat is mate in 1 in b2, b4, a5, attacking b4, knight in d3, a capture in b4, a capture in b4, queen in a6, putting the queen on the open file. Queen in A4, attacking the rook in D5, but before thinking what to do with this rook, we have rook in A7, of course he's mate here, with the queen in A1, king runs away in C1, but still we have queen in A1 we check, king in D2 is the only move, queen in C3 we check, king in E2, queen capture in C2 we check, and queen in F3. Now rook in A3, and of course here white can't capture the rook here, because after queen capture in D3, king in G4, queen in G6 we check, the only possibility is queen in G5, and H5 checkmate. So after rook in A3, with a double attack on the knight, white plays rook in D1. And now it's time to move this rook. Volkov plays the rook in B5, attacking this pawn because this knight is pinned. A fantastic idea instead of rook in B5 was to play rook in G5, because of course white can't capture the rook, because knight capture in G5 fork the king and the queen. So after rook in G5, the target for the checkmate is queen capture in G2, that must move away in G3. Now queen in C7, now the target becomes G3. So white should protect with rook in G1, rook in E5, attacking the queen, queen moves in G4. And now the fantastic queen in C2 that doubles the attack on the knight, but also threaten checkmate here in E2. And with best play, he checkmate in 8. So instead of this fantastic idea, Volkov plays the good move rook in B5. We have rook in one. Now rook capture in B4, because as we said the knight can't capture because he's pinned. King in G4 unpins the knight. Now H5 we check, and the king can't capture here in H5, because after rook in B5 we check, king must come back in G4, and we have F5 that fork king and queen. So after H5, we have king in F5, rook in B5 we check, the knight interpose coming to E5, but after queen in F2, white resigns because is checkmating too. Because after queen in F3, we have rook capture in F3, g capture in F3, and queen capture in F3. This is checkmate. So this was a very good win for Volkov in a classical French, and with this move we also end our analysis. I hope that you enjoyed the game, and if you did, please like the video and subscribe to the channel, because I will keep covering this strong tournament, and every week I will show you new fantastic chess games. Thanks for watching, see you soon, and goodbye.